What's up, guys? Pastor Rob here, back with another reaction video. As usual, I have my son Gage.
Hello.
And as usual, we're going to be reacting to a song requested by you guys in the comment section of our videos and offering a little biblical perspective on it. Now, keep in mind, this is not an endorsement of the song, the artist, or the genre as a whole, but an attempt to create discussion and encourage discernment while listening to music. If you want to know more about us, visit PastorRobReacts.com. Also, visit our sponsor, Fallen by Nature Christian Streetwear, at fallenbynature.com. And also, if you like what we do, please consider liking, subscribing, and joining our Patreon. Speaking of patrons, Everardo Gonzalez gets a shout out on the front end because he's our gracious giver.
Yep.
Thank you so much for that. You guys are the reason we have these lights on and are able to do these videos.
You guys are the reasons why we are able to eat more than two meals a day.
That's right. Thank you. Thank you very much for that.
Keep us fed.
Keep us fed. Thank you. He's skinny, as you could tell. So today's song is a song by the band Amongst the Giants. It's a song called Too Late from their album Obscene. These guys are a Christian band. From what I understand, they're a metalcore band from South Florida.
Whoa.
Florida represent.
Whoa.
That gets locals. Me excited. Yeah. Yeah, that's like cool. That. What's kind of cool is one of their family members, really close family member by the name of Chopper, reached out. Chopper. Probably sometime in April. You know, it's funny.
Yeah.
Don't make fun of the name. I'm just stopping you there. These are real human beings. But no, listen.
Name? Are you an anime villain?
I couldn't even laugh. Like, it hurt. No. Listen to this. One of my closest friends, and he was the center for my football team that I was a running back for, we called him Chopper. So when I heard the name, I was like, man, I thought of my old friend from back in the day. So to me, it's a special name. So Chopper, thank you for the suggestion. Also, I saw Contagion Fest, I think. Remember that? There was an online Christian festival, festival.
Like a stream kind of thing, right?
Yeah. And they were on there, and I happened to tune in right when they were on, and they did like an acoustic set. And I was like, these dudes are talented. So I'm pretty excited. And also, it just so happens that today, at the time of filming, is one of the members' birthdays, Marco, the bassist. Whoa.
Do we have to do it? Do I need to go get the guitar?
Happy birthday to you. Oh, boy. We're going to get a whole bunch of birthday shout-out requests now. That's just coincidence, I promise.
Quinky dink.
Anyway, they're an underground kind of band. I believe they're signed to a label. I can't recall the label name, but, you know, they're up and coming is probably a better way to say it. So I'm pretty excited to listen to their music, and hopefully you guys will enjoy it, too. You ready?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Another day, another death, another prison.
school bathroom. There's nothing more metal than that, huh? What?
Whoa.
Oh, wait a minute.
But wait, there's more.
I wonder if that guy's name's Chopper. Wow. Fantastic.
That was cool.
Dude, the video was great.
Yeah.
How cool was that to be able to, like, I'm assuming that was their school, maybe, or a school of some kind.
Yeah.
To be able to film in school, especially if it's your school that you went to, just kind of, I don't know. I think that was neat.
Yeah, that was cool. That.
The video imagery was good. What'd you think of the music? The
music was so sick.
Yeah?
It was pretty awesome. Dude,
I got to show you that set they did for the festival.
Yeah, I really liked it.
Yeah, it was really good. So, lyrically speaking, I want to comment on the music some more. So, like, definitely metalcore.
Definitely metalcore. I'd say it was more on the hardcore side of metalcore rather than the metal side.
Mm.
And I feel like there was definitely like some like emo kind of vibes.
Yeah, especially like the with vocals. The one singer, yeah.
Yeah, like the whiny style vocals, which I really like as much as a lot of people tend to hate. I think it's a pretty cool sound, honest.
What's that band you like?
Silverstein, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they're really good.
What's the other one you like? Green Day, right?
No. Not Green Day. Blink 182, a little bit, but like, yeah.
I'll leave you on that one.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I'll get some hate.
Didn't they tour with Lil Wayne?
Do I need to leave?
I like
Lil Wayne plays guitar. He's really good.
I've seen the video. I know what you're talking about. No.
I was hoping you'd be like, oh, really? I didn't know that. That's Google pretty cool. get some hate on Pastor Rob in the comments.
So the vocals were good as the video. The visuals in the video were great. You can obviously tell it was related to a school. It was related to violence. It was related to somebody who was bullied, somebody who was angry. In the video, it looks like he was thinking of taking his aggressor's life or then his own life in the end after he couldn't. So that's quite heartbreaking. There's obviously been a lot of school shootings throughout history. It seems like there's been a lot recently in recent years. They've always been around. They're just a little more publicized at this point. I'm not dismissing them at all. I'm just saying that,
I know
because we can see them, they impact us a lot more.
Yeah.
So the lyrics, too late, too late, too late for another tragedy. Again, got a school shooting.
Mm-hmm.
I'll wait for an ounce of sympathy.
Mm-hmm.
Have we come this far just to give up? Another day, another death, another helpless soul. It's easy to place blame on the outcast. So,
do you think this song is about a school shooting? Because, I don't know. Just the part where he says it's easy to place blame on the outcast, a broken heart, broken home.
Mm-hmm.
You could definitely
but
relate
that. No one
that.
Sees the toll. So like,
because there's statistics that point to school shooters, and a lot of them have pretty, not ideal backgrounds.
Sure. And that makes a lot of sense. A broken heart, so that's describing the person with a broken home.
Yeah.
But no one sees the toll that takes, having the broken heart and the broken home.
Yeah, so they're pretty much just suffering without any sort of recognition.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then it just
can't
builds
take
up.
Much more. So that's like it's about to blow up, right?
Yeah.
And then he goes back into the chorus, too late for tragedy. Are we desensitized, passively paralyzed? So even in the first chorus, he says, or in the intro, I'll wait for an ounce of sympathy. So he's like, and that's sort of sarcastic. I'll wait for that ounce of sympathy. Like even just a little bit of sympathy, bring it. And then he references that again by saying desensitized, passively paralyzed, like paralyzed and not even realizing it. We don't have any emotions. I'll wait. I grow more numb each day. Oh God, is it too late? So again, this growing numb idea points to desensitization.
Yeah.
The ground quakes and storms rage. What will it take to move you? So It's like you got earthquakes, storms, but what will it take to move you? What will it take? You have empty thoughts and prayers. That's what's that song we did? Thoughts and prayers.
Oh, Tool. I forget. Not Tool. It was Tool. Or no. Was it a Perfect Circle? Perfect yes, circle. It was a Perfect Circle.
Yeah.
That was actually a really good song. You know that what was it called?
Song. I enjoyed that song.
It's funny. Remember. We still use that song when we're setting up the headphones and checking the level. That's that's our test song.
Yeah. Adorable Crisis. Right? Yeah, I don't know. Empty thoughts, empty prayers. You type the words, but you don't really care. So again, you'll say stuff. Oh, such a tragedy, and then you hit enter, and you're done thinking about it. You've virtue signaled, as they say now. You never really cared. Is it too late to feel again? Too late for hope to win? When everything is said and done, is it too late for us? So the song is obviously about school shooting, violence of some kind. And desensitization. So, like, the word desensitized means to make emotionally insensitive or callous, specifically to extinguish an emotional response as of fear, anxiety, or guilt to stimuli that formerly induced it. Merriam-Webster's definition there. So, to be desensitized means you're callous emotionally. And there's no more emotional response like fear, anxiety, or even guilt to a stimuli that used to. So you don't feel anymore for the things that once used to make you feel. That's what it means to be desensitized. So we have such a interesting culture. So like when I was growing up, obviously tragedies existed.
Yeah.
But they were spread out as far as me knowing about them. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like, 'cause we didn't have Facebook feeds and all this stuff. So, like, you know, I remember I watched a space shuttle Challenger go off. I was outside at school.
Was that the one that, like, blew up?
Yeah, I was in third grade. That's watching crazy. It blew up. My teacher started crying. I didn't realize what happened because probably my first launch that I remember seeing. Really? And I was like, what happened? And we found out they died. And I mean, that bothered me all day. Like, I just watched people die. Are you kidding
me?
That
bothers me. And I didn't even see it. I haven't even seen the video.
Imagine little Bobby, you know?
Like, yeah.
Oh, my gosh. They're going to die, you know?
That's crazy.
Yeah, super crazy. So, I also remember another one, 1987, baby Jessica. Little girl, I think she was 18 months old, fell down a well pipe.
Really?
Yeah, dude. And it took them 2 days to rescue her. It's all you saw on the news at that time. They dug down, drilled, cut her out.
2 days?
2 days, bro. And again,
was she good?
She was good. Yeah. She traumatizing. Another one that really got me was, and this one happened, I was probably two, but I heard about it as I was getting older. It was the kidnapping of Adam Walsh. He was kidnapped from a Sears parking lot in Florida, not too far from where we lived. And 2 weeks later, they found his head in a drainage ditch. Oh, man, dude. Like, I mean, for a long time, you know, I was afraid to be alone in parking lots, you know, like a little kid, you know, scared out of my mind.
Yeah, that's rough.
Terrible, man. And really, honestly, I didn't see, like, today you can look online and see people's death, like their last days or their worst days. I mean, we didn't see any of that. Until I was a teenager, my friends rented this video from a series.
I've heard this one. This one's stupid.
Yeah. And I won't say the name of it, but it has to do with faces. Mm. And all it is people's last moments. Death.
Yeah.
Death. And of course, you know, I'm with my friends. You know, they rented Blockbuster. And I'm just sitting there like, I want to get out of here, but I can't. You know, the peer pressure thing. And
interesting fact. Mm-hmm. I think I can proudly say that I am the last generation to experience Blockbuster.
Oh, that's right. We went there?
Yeah. I got Meet the Robinsons. I bought it.
Yeah, cool.
That was my childhood movie. That's
cool. See that? Look at that. Something to be proud of.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, in my day, we didn't
Blockbuster was the Netflix.
It was the Netflix, yeah.
It was the Netflix.
So, but we didn't have, you know, back then, we didn't have social media. If you were to see the news, it was at night with your parents, and really you were wanting to hang out with your friends.
Yeah, books, just stuck at home. You know?
Yeah, play with your toys or whatever.
Yeah.
So, but now, I mean,
it's almost like, if you think about it, it's almost forced onto you.
It is.
Because if you actually try to avoid it, you really can't.
Mm-mm. No, you couldn't. Unless you got rid of all of your devices and turned off, but you'd still hear about it socially. but everybody around you still talk about it.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, did you hear? Yeah. TikTok's being banned.
Yeah, I'm thinking today, really?
Yeah.
Well, that's good news. There's some good news.
Yeah, right. I don't really Trump's actually trying to do that. Like, I was surprised.
But I even today, I was scrolling through and I see this guy shooting, you know, somebody, a protester doing this, you know, a police officer doing this. I mean, Karen. Anything you can think of, Karen, just all kind of stuff. Terrible news for the most part.
Especially happening. Karen's.
Yeah, and we got this pandemic, and we have a hurricane that was coming our way right now, into Florida. It's like all this stuff, and you're constantly stressed. And actually, the way I reacted to those death videos, I just scroll. That's all that's like. Like, I'm being desensitized.
Yeah.
In a way.
Yeah.
No longer lingers for much longer than the video than the clip scrolls past me.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Maybe that's part of getting older. Maybe.
Yeah.
But that's definitely.
I wonder if from like a psychological perspective, it's unhealthy. Like, is it unhealthy to be desensitized to certain things?
Ooh, I mean, that's a tangent right there.
This is a tangent. Well, my view on this, if it's a bad thing, like drugs, alcohol, if you're desensitized to that and you need more, but that's different. That's an addictive substance. Yeah, yeah. So I guess it's not the same type of desensitization.
So a good desensitization would be. You're desensitized to people pressuring you to doing drugs, for example.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Like true. People say, hey, man, hit this. And after a while, you know, the first time you're like, oh, what do I do? And after a while, bro, no.
Yeah.
It better be what you're saying. Nope.
Yeah.
Avoid that pitfall.
Uh-huh.
But we also get desensitized to things that are good. One of the most important things we've become desensitized to is God.
Yeah.
We've become, as a people, desensitized to how holy he is, his holiness, high and perfect and amazing, and is all of his attributes, his omnipotence, his omnipresence, like all these things that make God so great.
Yeah, I've always thought it was crazy. Like sometimes, like you'll hear something or like a sermon, and it just like hits different, and you realize like, wow, like it's almost like hearing it again.
Yeah, you're like, oh. Gee,
like, wait a minute. Like,
I've been thinking about that way. Yeah. Well, holiness, for example, R.C. Sproul has a series called The Holiness of God, and I was just showing a friend one of the segments of it.
Uh-huh.
And even when I got done, I went, man, I kind of, you know, God's holy. And with that, we need to realize the egregiousness of sin, like how bad sin is. You really can't see how bad sin is, our rebellion against God, our lack of conformity to his law and disobedience to his law until you know how good and perfect he is. You know what I mean? That same feeling you get when you get around a pastor or a preacher or a priest, even though, you know, it's a whole different thing. But still, you get around these people and all of a sudden you're like, ooh, sorry about that. Never fails. It's somebody like, we're talking to somebody for a while and they're like, so what do you do? I'm like, yeah, I'm a pastor.
Uh-huh.
Oh, my bad. Sorry for the language. You know, like all of a sudden they realize.
Yeah.
Like, man. And that's how it is with God. When you realize who he is, you realize who you are.
Mm.
And then with that, you realize the depth of God's grace and mercy for forgiving us how vile we are compared to how great he is, how unworthy. Nobody likes hearing that. How unworthy we are. We're not used to that as Americans. We're worthy. Right, you owe me that. Like, give me my stimulus check.
Yeah. Yeah. That's just like what we talked about in the last video that we did.
Breaking Benjamin.
Yeah. Breaking Benjamin. Your most righteous works are but filthy rags.
Filthy rags.
We're not worthy.
Not worthy. Even your best is not good enough.
Yeah.
And all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. That's what it means to fall short of God's glory. We fall short of his standard, who he is, his glory.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Right? But is it too late? Is it too late? So it's not too late. It's not too late. Like, I think the answer to desensitization, this is going to be corny, resensitization. I just made that up. If that's not a word, I don't know.
What is resensitization?
This is applicable to anybody, really. But for those who have received the gospel, have the Spirit of God, we're right now being sanctified. That's being made more and more like Christ, more and more like God, who is holy.
Yeah.
We'll never be holy and perfect on this earth. That's called glorification. That happens later.
Mm-hmm.
But with that, we have a new heart and we become more like Christ. We're able to do that. Our heart's different. And Christ was sensitive enough to cry even when his friend died, Lazarus.
Yeah.
Knowing that he was going to resurrect him. Like, he didn't cry and go, oh, snap, I got this power. Lazarus, come forth. Right?
Yeah. That's crazy. That definitely shows, that really displays the fact that he was also man as well as God.
Yeah, the hypostatic union, yeah.
Yeah.
He was compassionate. He knew, as God, as a man, that Lazarus and his family were suffering.
Yeah, because crying, definitely, I would say, is a trait of man.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely, 100%. You're absolutely right. That's very good. That's good theology right there. That's one of the attributes of man right there.
Yeah, so that really displays the hypostatic union.
Yeah, absolutely. So my point there is that through the Spirit, we can become more sensitive. I have to stop and say, as a believer, your level of sensitization is not a prerequisite for salvation. Like, you don't have to be sensitive to be saved.
Yeah.
You're a mess. You're a sinner. That's what we are. We're sinners who are, we're fallen by nature and saved by grace.
Yeah.
Nothing to do with our works. So we're going to mess that up. But for practical living, and there's a verse that I always think about when I think about this stuff, and it's Philippians chapter 4, verse 8. Paul's closing his letter to the Philippians. He's in prison, by the way, suffering. And he leaves them with this. He says, finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Mm. We don't do that. Yeah. We're constantly mulling over tragedy.
Yeah, you're right. I completely agree with that.
Yeah. It's like Psalm 119:37. Turn my eyes from looking at worthless things and give me life in your ways. Mm. If you want life in God's ways, turn your eyes away from worthless things. Don't look at that stuff if you can. If you're following news organizations that share that or meme groups or whatever it is that puts that stuff in front of you that's desensitizing you, it's hurting you.
Yeah, it's really counterproductive if you think about it.
So remove yourself from that. Focus on what's true.
Yeah.
Focus on what's honorable. Can you think of honorable things on the news? Not usually.
No.
Just. We think we know what justice is. We don't, because we have such corrupt politicians, such corrupt judges, and everybody's got their opinions and everything's all politicized. We don't know justice.
Yeah.
God knows justice. Mm-hmm. Whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, if there's anything worthy of praise, think about these things. So as you go forward in life, try to find some of these things. Find this verse, Philippians 4:8. And try to find things that you can think about that line up with these things, and avoid the things that don't. Think about these things and you become resensitized. Your heart will begin to hurt for those who mourn. Your heart will begin to break for those who suffer.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. If there's anything I can say about this song, it was really good. And it was a really good reminder that even myself, as a believer for quite some time now, can and has become desensitized in a lot of ways.
Yeah.
And in a lot of ways, I haven't been following what Paul said here in Philippians. You know, I've spent a lot of time thinking about all this stuff, you know, and anti-mask or to wear a mask or vaccine or not to vaccine or hydrochloroquine, whatever that is, or this doctor versus that doctor is Fauci. All this stuff is constantly rolling through my head. And these things you've got to think about, but don't forsake thinking about these things as well, or think about them in light of these things.
Yeah, that's great.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen. Well, guys, thank you for watching the video. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Also, consider joining our Patreon, as we mentioned at the beginning of the video. Mm-hmm. All the links will be down in the description of that. And follow us on social media and visit our sponsor, fallenbynature.com. Yep. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, hit me up. You can find me on Facebook through Messenger, Instagram through the DM. And until the next video, may the light of the Lord continue to shine on you. Peace.